So, hello guys. Hari ini aku akan buat top 10 listing from Steam Winter Sale ending year 2020. So, list yang aku bagi ini adalah dalam random order. Tak ada game paling best ataupun paling tak best dalam list saya ini. So, maybe games kita akan ada persamaan ataupun tidak, ataupun akan mengejutkan anda. So mind you, the listing macam saya cakap tadi, not in particular order. So without further ado, let's get to my first top 10. For those yang miss the Cyberpunk train, you guys really should try this game, which is I played all the series, and this game should be worthy of entering any of your Steam library. Aku dah main game ni dalam dekat 40 jam lah. Yang ni adalah version Game of the Year. So Deus Ex, Mankind Divided,
PEGI 18,
is one of the best for me in terms of storyline. Side quest are not that heavy. The weapons are more or less macam Cyberpunk, tapi yang ini dia lebih close-ended lah. The quests are also more close daripada open. Macam Cyberpunk, dia open-ended. Depends on your activity in the city. This one is not based on the city. It depends on the main quest itself. Tapi side quest dia akan ada kaitan sikit dengan main quest lah. So for this Steam sale, it's only selling for RM28.50. If you guys want to try another best shot, this one should be in your list as well. Grafik agak kuno sebab game ni lama dah. Aku time sekolah rendah lagi dah keluar, 1998-1999 macam tu. Tapi sekarang RM2.38 je, tak rugi pun. And then the other one in the series is Deus Ex Human Revolution. So this is the origin story of Mr. Adam Jensen lah. Tapi yang Game of the Year edition yang lama ni tak ada kaitan dengan dua ni tadi lah. So for you guys, if you want to get the collection bundle, just get it. So if you want to try with your recent PC, just get this one. So this is in my top 10. Bukan dia tak best, kenapa dia masuk top 10? Sebab I think the exposure should be there. More people should try this game. So my number 9 will be maybe Doom Eternal. I don't play it, but the original Doom, okay lah. Sekarang masih murah dan aku baru main 2 jam. Doom 3 ini 70%. This is close corridor shooter. Yang ni pun tak heavy sangat dan dia bukan macam Cyberpunk. Ni macam, kalau korang ingat lagi, Serious Sam lah. Style of play dia macam tu lah. This deserves in your GOTY library as well. So number 8 for me will be this one. Yang ni siri paling latest daripada Metro. Okay. Game ni pun best. Aku dah beli dekat Epic Store. That's why I don't buy from this. I buy from Epic last year sebab dia exclusive dekat Epic Games. So, so this one, I already put a few hours there. Storyline dia okay, not as open world, linear shooter lah. Tapi still one of the best for me. So it deserves number 8. So for my number 7, Kalau korang minat open-ended world, this one deserves your attention. Grafik mungkin tak semegah Cyberpunk, tapi realism game ni adalah antara yang terbaik lah. So this one deserves to be in your list. Kalau korang terlepas peluang untuk ambil di Epic Games dulu, dia ada buat giveaway, if I'm not mistaken lah. Dulu dia bagi giveaway premium edition, so this one should be in your list as well, GTA 5. So for me this is number 7 lah after Metro Exodus. So another one, 6, should be in your list is this game, Hitman series. Sama juga open world dan dia punya side quest revolves around the map, tapi kalau korang jenis yang run and gun, main Call of Duty, ya ini tak sesuai lah. Tapi for me, story driven quest dia not bad lah. So take this for granted and try playing this if you haven't. Would be a healthy addition to your Steam library. So number 5 for me, ya ni jangan skip. Ya ni kalau tak main agak rugi lah, Batman Arkham series. So number 6 tadi Hitman. Hitman 1 korang try lah. Tapi yang number 5 ni no one should miss, because this series are one of the best. Batman Arkham City, Arkham Knight and Arkham Asylum, semua pada harga RM34, memang berbaloi lah boy. Aku dulu dapat I don't get it in Steam sale, tapi tak apa sebab aku dah beli full Arkham collection ni. Arkham collection, tapi bukan dekat aku punya Steam library. Yang ni aku dah habis lah. Yang ni aku belum main lagi. And this one is also I skip for a while sebab aku nak main dekat PC yang ada TV 4K nanti. So maybe next time I will play this. So Arkham series deserves my number 5 spot. Okay, number 4. Kalau korang tak kenal, game ni memang tak cinta lah. GOTY Edition number 4 for me should be apa eh, pening kepala aku nak pilih. Should be SEO DC lah. SEO Origins best, tapi dia macam lari sikit daripada story Assassin's Creed sebelum ni. Dan aku lupa disclaimer, semua dalam list aku ni aku pilih top 10 yang below RM100, sebab they really deserve to be on your Steam library for less than 100. Tengok aku beli Gold Edition dekat Epic Games, memang sangat baloi. Dulu pun aku beli dalam harga RM60 atau silap. Dan dia come free dengan Assassin's Creed 3 Remastered. So this deserves to be in your Steam library for sure. Number 4. Dia far better daripada Origin, Syndicate, Black Flag dengan SC Unity all together. So you shouldn't skip this. So number 3 for me is this one. Ya ni kalau korang pengguna Steam, memang sah korang jangan skip yang ini. Orange Box RM7 je boy, takkan tak nak ambil. Yang ni aku dah main semua, memang padu. Dan ya ini pun, nah ini dia modded, lebih modern, grafik dia pun mantap, tapi storyline dia lebih kayak macam Half-Life 1 lah. Kalau tak silap dulu Orange Box dia include Left 4 Dead, kalau tak silap. Itu macam mana tuh, aku pun lupa dah. Kenapa dia tak include eh? Not sure. Last time they include ini Valve Complete Pack Bundle. Not sure whether how why they don't include this. Last time ya ni apa eh? Sekarang lupa lah. I try to keep first. Okay, not lah. Dulu aku beli RM12 tapi semua game sini memang legend lah, worthy of any of you punya Steam library top 3. This deserves to be in your top 3. Okay, for number 2 will be a very susah speed sebab nombor 1 aku dah ada dalam mindset, tapi nombor 2 ni agak payah sikit. Okay, so number 2 for me should be this one. I played this using other person's account, tapi yang ni dia keluar sikit lah daripada aku punya apa list bawah satu singgit. Tapi yang ni even 146, maybe after a year or two dia akan drop macam GTA tadi lah. You guys really should get this. Red Dead Redemption 2 dah menang banyak award Game of the Year, so I think should be a worthy edition. Kalau miss Cyberpunk, you shouldn't miss this. Red Dead Redemption punya storyline okay, cuma dia agak open ended lah. And the number one game for me, macam aku cakap tadi, dah berulang-ulang aku mention Cyberpunk kan. So CDPR really should get this title to be recognized. So korang boleh type this one. And this deserves to be my number one list. Aku dah replay banyak kali. Dan ini adalah tipu sebab aku guna account adik aku untuk main game ni. But I already finish include Blood and Stone ke apa tah? Blood and Wine dengan House of Stone. Semua apa DLC aku dah habis. Game of the Year dia baru RM38. So memang totally worth it. Dan aku habiskan game ni from January until June kot, tahun 2000 apa lah. Aku main time tu aku guna Celeron lagi G4560, Pentium G4560 dengan GTX 1060. So this game, totally recommended. So I already bought it for I don't bought this lah. Why don't I bought this? Oh, sebab DLC dia dah habis. Dan aku rasa No Man's Sky layak. Last year aku dah bought, tapi tahun ni aku bought game lain pula. Yeah, I voted this one to be cerita dia. Okay, so this one is bonus. Why I don't include this? Because I haven't played it, of course. And I think I give this chance to flourish dulu. Walaupun DLC, bukan DLC, dia punya free patch dah banyak. Tapi bagi aku, game ni memang deserve a title of Labor of Love. Sebab developer dia memang tak putus-putus baiki game ni. But for me, this game is perfect. So I think that's all. Depends on you whether you want to buy or not. Tapi saya bepang, memang aku dah settle lah. Dah main 30 jam kot. Okay, 37.3 hours. Lagi banyak jam aku spend dekat sini daripada this X Mankind Divided tadi. Game world ni memang besar ke dapat. So for you missing out on Cyberpunk ataupun tunggu Cyberpunk ni harga murah sikit, you guys better get this one. Witcher 3 dah ada dalam Netflix, tinggal season 2. So this game deserve to be in your top 10 library. Okay, that's all. Okay, bye.